Hey guys, this is Bandai4, bringing you a brand new Let's Play, Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening. Though this is not an April Fool's joke, I'm actually doing this like I always do on April Fool's Day. Well, not always a new Let's Play, but I always put something up on this day. So, I'm just gonna get right into this game. And Link's tossing around. What a relief. I thought you'd never wake up. You're tossing and turning. What? Zelda? No, my name's Marin. You must still be feeling a little woozy. You're on Colin Island. So you actually have to move the island. Well, Link, you finally snapped out of it. Name's Taren. Hope you're feeling better. What? How did I know your name? You think it's weird, eh? Well, I saw them back with this shield. So, right off the bat, you get your shield. It actually does something. It sets it automatically to B. I don't like it on B. I like it on A, so I'm going to put it right there. Chickens. But first thing you want to do, just get out of the town, go to the beach, because the beach is awesome. But also, if you talk more to people, they'll tell you, no, that's where they found you, and you don't have a sword. And swords kind of helpful when you're trapped somewhere. This is not the fastest way to go, but I forgot. So, if you see these spiky guys all over the place, you need to push them with your shield, at least when you don't have a sword. And my favorite character.
Hoot, hoot. So you're a lad who wants a sword. Now I understand why the monsters are starting to act so violently. The courageous lad has come to wake the windfish. It is said that you cannot leave the island unless you wake the windfish. You should now go north to the mysterious forest. I will wait for you there. Hoot.
Yes, the owl. His first appearance in the series. And you get your sword. And this is my favorite version of the main Legend of Zelda theme in the entire series. So I'm going to let it play for a moment once it starts here. Okay, that's plenty. So when you pick up your sword, the little spiky guy in that screen just gets destroyed. And we're in the first little area, so everything gets killed in one hit. But we go right back into town. And while I can do a few things in town right now, I'm going to continue straight to the North Forest, because I'll get rupees there. And for what I want to do, I need rupees. So come on up.
Oh, brave lad. On your quest to wake the dreamer, welcome to the mysterious wood. Much of mystery you will find on this uncharted Covalent Island. I'm afraid you may find it a trifle difficult to leave the island while the windfish naps. By the by, have you ever visited the Tail Cave, which is south of the village? Go there with the key you find in this forest. The windfish is watching. Hoot.
Yes, very big island. Press select to bring up the map. You can only see what you've already been to, and even some of those places will just have question marks. So, it's a fairly big map, but this is not a terribly long game, and there are very few pieces of heart. There are a bunch of dungeons, and only 16 hearts total. So this is a Guardian Acorn. It appears like every 16 or so enemies that you destroy. It reduces the damage you take by half until you, I think until you leave the area, and there's some other criteria for it as well. I don't particularly care for Guardian Acorns. If I go that way, nothing good happens. What I want to do first is go through this little cave here. And there'll be some keys in here. They're annoying. Terribly annoying. You want to break these crystals. And fall in the hole, you know, if you feel like it. Okay, they're dead. So break the crystals, push that out of the way, open this chest, and you get 50 rupees. Which is why I wanted to come up here before exploring the town a little more. Come up here and some shoes will appear from the ground. These ones die right away, some others split into smaller ones. I'll show you some of those soon. Come out here, and there's a little mushroom here that you need to pick up. Unless you're a speedrunner, then you don't need to pick up this toadstool. If you're a speedrunner, you bypass that toadstool, you lure this moblin on the bottom up to hit you over this hole, and then you can get over to that treasure chest over there. But I'm not a speedrunner, at least not of this game, so I'm just going to go right back through the cave. Go through the cave, not back out. I pushed that wrong. I'm good at this game, I promise. At least better than I am at Zelda 2. So push this up and come out here. I talked about my experiences with previous Zelda games when I first started playing them, so I guess I'll take this opportunity traveling back to do that. This was the second Zelda game I played after the original, and maybe even the second game that I beat ever. I remember many, many long days spent on the Game Boy with its four AA batteries playing this game. And, we did have a Game Genie for the NES, and to be fair, I probably used it a fair bit for this game. But, every game that I beat using a Game Genie in the past, I have now beaten, legitimately. And this is one of those games, and this game probably has my favorite music in the entire series, including my favorite song, period, in the Zelda series, and you'll hear it before too much longer. Have to ignore that piece of heart right now, and I adore this game, really I do. If you're wondering why I chose not to play the color version, I do have, actually, two cartridges of the color version, but I wanted to play the version that was what I first played, and I may at some point do the color dungeon since I do have that, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. So the toadstool, the switch wants it. Ah, that's a sleepy toadstool, it does. We'll mix up something in a jiffy, we will, and spin, 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 and we will get magic powder. Now, if you don't want to get this magic powder, you can buy it in the shop. Not buy it in the shop. You can get it from a crane minigame. So if you sprinkle it there, it lights up the hut. It doesn't actually do anything for you. So if you don't want to light up the hut, save yourself the magic powder, because you won't get anything for it. We have to ignore that heart piece again. Because there are no enemies to hit me over the hole in that area. By the way, these shoes are the ones that split up. This smaller shoes don't hurt you when they jump on you, but they slow down your movement, and that's just annoying. I'm gonna kill this guy. Okay. I took damage doing it, but hey, why not? So, what you actually... I'm going the wrong way. What you actually need this powder for is you come up here and you see this... I'm going to call it the Tanuki. He calls himself a raccoon, but Tanukis are the tricksters. So if you try to go up, you're going to be lost thanks to me. And it'll play a little song telling you that you went the wrong way. And it'll get you all confused. So, what you do instead of getting lost is you pull your own little trick. Tricks on April Fools. Here's some powder. And he bounces around. Achoo. Last thing I can remember was biting into a big juicy toadstool. Then, I had to die in this dream. I was a raccoon. Yeah, sounds strange, but it sure was fun. Yeah, fun for you, not for any travelers. I'm all tucked out. Think I better set the spell before I head home. So, he's gonna do that. And now this treasure chest. Ready for an owl? You got the tail key. Now you can open the tail cave gate.
Take the key and go to the tail cave. Retrieve the instrument that is hidden there. Go now. The windfish is waiting. Hoot.
I do love the owl, but boy, he sure can talk sometimes. So, I have the key, and you can see it in the corner of the bright bit of the screen there. And that will allow me access to the first dungeon, which I'm going to try not to die in, because I made fun of so many other LPers for doing so. So, you know, if I go and die there, then, well, that's just sad. I'm going to do a little bit more before this first episode is over, you know. Kind of give you something a bit more substantial. It's been so long since I uploaded, and you deserve it. So, I'm going to come over here to this little shop. And if you talk to this guy, hey man, when you're on the save, just push all the buttons at once. I tried that. Don't ask me what that means. I'm just a kid. I tried that. Pushing all the buttons at once. Really? Oh. Well, I'll save. Ow. Sorry about that. I'll be back. Okay, I'm almost back in the town. So, obviously, on Super Nintendo games, you push start, select, L, and R, and that'll do it. But I have to remember on the Game Boy, there is no L and R. So I need to push start, select, A, and B, and that'll bring it up. I'm wasting more magic down there. So, I'm playing on the Super Game Boy. I do not use emulators for my LPs, and unless I do a ROM hack, I never will. So, come to this little shop here, and talk to this guy. Trinity game, 1 play, 10 rupees. So, I will play. A and B buttons move the crane, the rest is just timing. Go over to the buttons to play. Good luck. So, you can see magic powder there, you can see a shield, if your shield gets messed up. Rupees hearts. But what you want is that little Yoshi doll in the middle. So, get it right about there. It's probably wrong. No, good enough. You want to kind of line up your shadow with the thing, but obviously it's not super picky. And the Yoshi doll is just sitting in the middle by itself, so it's not moving like everything else. So, yeah. So recently it seems to be showing up in many games. This was before. No, it was after Super Mario World, so it had a fairly big role in that. He also had the NES game called Yoshi, one of those early puzzle games. I actually have that game. It's pretty fun. There's more I can do in town right now. I'm gonna show this eventually, I may as well. Like any good Zelda game, attack the chickens, and sooner or later... Seriously, sooner or later. There we go. Chickens will attack you. They will probably kill you if you're not careful. So let's get out of there. This game also have... By the way, I do not condone the attacking of chickens. I also do not condone attacking dogs. But if you hit it, it will leap at you. So, don't actually hit those animals. But if you do in this game, be prepared to be attacked. This chain chomp is not going to hurt you. Yes, I know it's in that well. I will be picking that up later. Because I don't want to make graphics right now, and I'm going to make graphics for the heart pieces again. So, come over this way, and you can't jump over that hole. You'll be able to eventually. By the way, if you see something like a hole on the way to a dungeon, you can be pretty sure that what lets you bypass whatever that obstacle is, you're probably going to get in the dungeon you're coming towards. Death by falling. And Open this. This is the first dungeon. And Noelle, this toss you after the dungeon. Anyway, I'm gonna call that first episode here. We got the game started off. I told you some stuff. I made some mistakes. Just a typical first episode of Let's Play. So, in the next part, I'll be entering the Tail Cave and hopefully not dying. But I will see you guys then.